Hi, my name is Manuel Ikani and I am the Dean and Professor of Orthodontics at CTOR Academy. Welcome to CTOR channel. And the topic of discussion today is different type of tooth movement. How many type of tooth movement we can have? Let's categorize them in three groups. The first group is considered displacement. You are familiar with this one. I talked about it in previous sessions. During the displacement, the center of resistance move in this space. And along the center of resistance, all the points in the tooth move in the same direction with the same distance. The second group of movements is rotation. During the rotation, pure rotation, the center of resistance does not move, but all the points of the tooth rotates around the center of resistance. Some of them that are closer rotate less, some of them that are farther, of course, rotate more. These are the main two group of movement in orthodontics. But we have the third group that is a combination of these two pure movement. Let's call all together tipping. So the third category is called tipping. Three type of tipping is very important for us in orthodontics. One is control tipping, we call it, where the apex of the tooth stays stationary, and it seems that the whole tooth rotates around the apex. The second group are called uncontrolled tipping, where the apex moves one side, crown moves in the other side, and it seems that the tooth is rotating around the point between the apex and center of resistance. It's a very common movement in orthodontics. The third group of tipping, that movement that we are interested in, is root movement. It seems that the incisal edge has not moved and the root has been moved in one direction. If you notice, when I'm talking about the different type of tooth movement, it took me time to describe them. Is it an easier way so we can communicate faster? One of the important concepts when it's coming to defining the different type of tooth movement is center of rotation. Let's describe all the movements that so far we learned using the center of rotation concept. Pure rotation, the center of resistance does not move and all the points rotate around the center of resistance. We can say that in pure rotation, the center of resistance and center of rotations are the same. One of the characteristics of center of rotation, therefore, is there is no displacement. It stays stationary, is the only point that stays stationary. The second one, the control tipping. What is the center of rotation here? As we describe this control tipping, we say that it seems that the apex doesn't move. So you can describe that the apex is the center of rotation. And if you look at the picture, the green point shows the center of rotation, while the red point shows the center of resistance. Center of resistance displaced, but center of rotation stays the same place. How about uncontrolled tipping? Can you guess where is the center of rotation? Again, in uncontrolled tipping, the center of resistance displaced inside the space. In this picture, you can see the red dot is moving the space. However, there is a point between the apex and center of resistance that seems stationary, and that will be the center of rotation. How about root movement? Do you remember when I was defining the root movement? I said that it's a movement that the crown stays stationary. However, the roots moves. So if I'm designing the root movement, you can assume the center of rotation would be incisal edge in this picture, the green dot. So far I was talking about the center of rotation for the different type of tooth movement, but I didn't talk about the center of rotation for displacement or translation. Where would be the center of rotation for this type of tooth movement? It seems there is no rotation. Well, mathematically, we can assume every translation also is a rotational motion, but the center of rotation is far, far, far away from us. Assume the center of rotation is in another star. In that case, the movement still can be described as a rotation with the center of rotation in infinity. Now, the next questions that we have, how we can find the center of rotation? It's simple. Just grab two points of your target or object that you have. For example, in this discussion, the tooth. Let's for simplicity assume a point in the apex and a point in the crown, and draw a line between the before movement and after movement, between the apex in this example and between the incisal edge in this example. And then bisect each one of these lines with another perpendicular line, And let's see these two perpendicular lines where they cross each other. That point is center of rotation. Type of movement in different dimensions can be different. So far, we look at the tooth in a sagittal view, and we were looking at how the tooth moves in a space. How about occlusal view? First order view, if you remember from previous session. Can we have the similar type of tooth movement in this view? Let's look at the displacement or translation in this view. If the center of resistance of the tooth is in the center of the tooth, that point moves in a space, and all points on the occlusal view of this tooth move with the center of resistance the same amount and in the same direction. In the pure rotation, the tooth rotate around the center of resistance. In another word, assuming the center of resistance is in the center of the occlusal table, the center of rotation would be the center of resistance. The buccal cusp goes one direction, while the palatal cusp goes in opposite direction. How about control tipping? In control tipping, assume either buccal cusp or palatal cusp stays stationary and the rest of the tooth rotate around that cusp. In this example, we decided that buccal cusp stays stationary and the root and the whole occlusal table rotate around that point. How about uncontrolled tipping? In this case, the tooth rotate around the point between the center of resistance and one of the cusp, buccal or palatal. So buccal cusp goes one direction, palatal cusp goes another direction, and center of resistance also displaces inside the space. If you remember when we were talking about the center of resistance, I said it doesn't matter from where you look at it. It's always one point as a center of resistance. We can look at a different dimension, but the point stays the same. How about center of rotation? If teeth have different type of tooth movement in different dimension, for example, they can have a bodily movement or displacement in one direction, and they have rotation, uncontrolled tipping in another dimension, therefore they have different center of rotation in different dimension. So center of rotation is not the same in different dimension. It's not like center of resistance, but it varies based on dimension. Thank you again for watching another session of CTOR channel. Please support us by subscribing to our channel and also pressing the like button. That way we know that you are enjoying these sessions and you like us to continue. Thank you again.